Welcome to the ITDVDs.com YouTube channel. This is just a sample of the training available at ITDVDs.com. If you would like to see complete training, please go to ITDVDs.com. Now let's begin the sample. There are several ways we can purchase Windows 7 licenses. We may buy a computer that already has Windows 7 on it and licensed. We may buy a box of Windows 7 from our local computer store, and that box has the Windows 7 installation DVD in it. And on the DVD case, the serial key is printed on it to activate Windows 7. Or we may even buy it from an online retailer like CDW. But what about if we need to buy more than just a couple Windows 7 licenses? Let's say we need to buy 50 or 100 or even 1,000. Well, if we purchase those in a one-off fashion, it could become unmanageable very fast because we have all these different serial keys that we have to keep track of, and they're all going to be printed on the DVD cases. So when we go to deploy Windows 7, it's going to be very, very difficult because each Windows 7 deployment is going to have a separate serial key, and somehow we have to add that key to our deployment or go around to each computer and manually input that key. Well, this is where Microsoft Volume Licensing comes in. And Microsoft Volume Licensing isn't just for the big, huge companies. Even if you have as little as 5 computers in your environment, you can get a Microsoft Volume Licensing agreement. You can see here I am on Microsoft Volume Licensing homepage. I'm in the small organization section, and there are a couple agreements or programs for smaller companies like Open Value Subscription, Open License. For mid-size organizations, there's Open Value Subscription, Select Plus, and Enterprise Agreement. And for large organizations, there's Enterprise Agreement, Enterprise Subscription Agreement, and Select Plus. They even have volume licensing agreements that are tailored to specific organizations like government, education, health, charities, independent software vendors, and service providers. So you can see there are a number of different volume licensing agreements, and it's important to pick the correct one for your company. And in this training, we're not going to go in depth into each different type of volume licensing agreement, but what we are going to talk about is one of the main benefits, aside from saving money by using a volume licensing agreement, is that you get two different types of keys. You can get a MAC key, which is a multiple activation key, or a KMS key, which is a key management services key. And these two types of keys allow us to deploy Windows 7 and other operating systems like, you know, Windows Server 2008 R2 in a much more efficient fashion. And managing our serial keys becomes really, really easy. But again, in order to get these MAC and KMS keys, you have to have a volume licensing agreement. So now let's talk about in detail what a MAC key is, what a KMS key is, when we're going to use it, and how to implement those two different types of keys when we deploy Windows 7.